Hi, Dr. Lindsey and Wendy here. This is a 5-month update on 1,000 FUEs on a black guy's frontal hair transplant. And the fellow is a really nice guy from Central Virginia who brought me bagels when he came up from my favorite place to eat. And he had this frontal hair tuft before. And he'd actually gone to see a dermatologist that I went to med school with, who had done a bunch of PRP shots on him and didn't get much success. And she referred him up to see me. And we had a pretty blunt discussion on he's likely to lose significantly more hair as he ages, but he wanted FUE. And I didn't disagree with that because he's got the advantages of African-American hair. Those roots are fat and they're resilient. So if you can find the angle to get those hairs, they live like my chinny chin hairs. They're good hairs. They're hard to kill if you can get them out. And so we laid him down and made holes for 4 hours and got just right around 1,000 grafts. And he had his assistant, who was very similar to you, sit with him the whole time.
She was nice.
She's a really nice girl. And we put him in, and he went back home, and what did you guys do, Skype or FaceTime?
We FaceTime every day. His assistant would clean him, and she would, like, update me every day on his progress.
And so here he is a couple days out, and then he sent pictures every week. So here's 1 week, here's 2 weeks, here's 3 weeks as the hair is starting to go away, and then you might have gotten a few more emails, but then here he is at 5 months, and his before picture's up to the other side, and he looks good. And he had a question about what was going on back in the center of his head, and we had to remind him we didn't do anything there. We only worked in the front of his head. So this is 5 months, and really only half of them are grown. But the advantage of that black guy hair is it's so curly and it covers so well, like boxwood bushes do, as compared to, I don't know, marigolds or something with a skinny type of plant. And so he'll look even better. And here's a close-up of his donor area that he did a selfie on. I guess it's not a close-up, but he did the best selfie he could do and sent it up to us. And you really can't see anything. So
yeah, looks very natural. There's no.
So FUE is certainly a reasonable option for a fellow like this with resilient hair, and who really wears a short haircut and doesn't want to take a chance with a linear scar. The really key is you got to find the right angle, right?
Yes.
If you can find that, we can get the hair out without transecting it, it works great. It's hard to find that right angle because it's like with an FUE punch, you're coming in over top of a hair. But if the hair is curly, it's like trying to find the right angle over a corkscrew. And it can be difficult.
They work great.
And once you find the angle in one spot, the doctor and Wendy and I get kind of cocky, and we go, and then you find that the hair angle changes. And so it takes a lot of effort and concentration. There's no chance that one of those machines can whip out 1,000 FUEs in an hour when it takes us 4 or 5 hours to find the right angles on a curly-haired fellow. Right?
Yeah, I think what people don't understand sometimes is the different textures that you can find in the same head.
Right.
And you can definitely see, like, one is really hard, other one's really squishy, and then the other one is just, you have to feel it.
Yeah.
You have to, you know, and you have to have that sense. I guess machines don't have that.
Yeah. It's hard. I mean, it took us a couple years to figure that out on our own.
Yes.
So you can figure a machine or a newbie is not going to know that. Well, if we can help you, please give us a call. Thanks.